No, not that part. Not that part again.
Oh my God. I wish you all could be on this bike. Of course we'd be over the weight limit, but and feel this wind that I'm coming across. Oh my God. Yeah, have you ever done something that you know you weren't really prepared for, but you did it anyway, and all the way through it you were nervous as hell, and the ride up here wasn't so bad. I did have to ride about 15 miles on a true interstate with a lot of traffic, with the high winds, by the way. Well, that wasn't too fun. But anyway, I don't have a whole lot to talk about. If I talk about anything, I'd get off on those, you know, the way people act on forums again, and I really don't want to do that. I'm done with that. Even though I'm a little bit pissed about it, you know, I'm just not going to obsess about it. So, I'm just going to let it go, and that's just how it is. No longer frequent that form, so there's really nothing more to bitch about. They're lost. Okay, last time. Somewhere up here, this road gets cool. But it's been a long time since I've been on it, so I don't know where. I got 30 minutes of video. That won't quite get me to Louisiana, Missouri, I don't think, which is the next town, south of Hannibal, but it'll get me through the bulk of this road, and then after I'm done with that, I'll go through Louisiana, head back west, and I'll be about an hour away from home at that point, so I'll have to gas up in Louisiana, and let's see, I went 89 miles on this tank, so I've got roughly 100 or so more miles that I can go. You know, I really probably should have filled up. I know it's not 100 miles, but with the wind and You know, there's nothing between here and there, so I mean, not the greatest of ideas. We'll see. This country this area is just absolutely—it's just beautiful when it's all greened out. Okay, well, it's only 23 miles, so lock and damn. Worked for a finance company for a long time, and somewhere out here, there's a little, you can almost say a village of like 8 or 10 houses, and they're all up on stilts. They're right next to the river, and it constantly floods. Basically, you walk over to these houses, they got a great big huge stairs and a boat attached to them. And I remember one time having to come out here, and I think it's farther up the road here, but I had to actually come down to the end of the road, take my shoes and socks off, roll up my pants leg, and wade over to this guy's house. Yeah, it was that serious. So yeah, you kind of hear banjos when you go in this part of the country. But I'm sure you have those people everywhere. Another thing is my light, or my, I think my battery. Very low light flashing. Well, we'll see how long we get on it. It was a full charge, so I gotta think that I got more than 30 minutes left. How's that for a shot? That's about as good as it gets right there. That's cool. Well, not as good as it gets, but it's pretty damn cool. That's over in Illinois right there. We're right on the edge of Missouri. Yeah, I figure this is a good experience, me riding in this wind on a, not a dangerous road, but you know, hell, what am I trying to say? One that takes a little bit of, you know, paying attention on. So the next time I go out, and I'm riding with a bunch of people, and they want to go out in the wind, I won't be afraid to do it because I've done it before. It's not so bad. I find that if I kind of crouch down and kind of tuck and put my elbows on my knees, this is only on the highway, and then lower my head down about as far as I can get it and still be able to see that. Well, first of all, it gets loud as hell, but I lower my wind resistance. I've got a double bubble windshield coming. It was supposed to be here today or tomorrow, but I just got an email from the guy saying it's back ordered. It'll be another week or two, so oh well, I get it soon enough. I also ordered the book, oh shit. Yeah, no, it's not called Oh Shit. It's a book that Fit Writer had in his gear that he, you know, he uses. It just got a great big motorcycle wheel on the front. Crap. Oh well, I'll put it, you know, like down in here when I edit. But I'll get that in the next couple days too. And get to reading on that. That, and I also bought a book that's, I also put the link down here too. It's supposed to be really good. It's about this guy that, this doctor that tours all over the country, and he gives you tips and tricks to stay safe, save money, whatever. So that's what I'll be reading over the next several weeks, because that is what I want to do with this hobby. I mean, I don't want to just, I'm not using it for commuting. That's not what it's going to be all about. It's going to be about me going out and, you know, seeing as much of the country on two wheels as I possibly can.